Hey guys! I'm so excited about this lesson today! Our core scripture for this lesson is coming out of Mark 16:17 through 18. And these signs shall follow them that believe, and my name shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. There's more to the scripture, but we're only going to focus on this portion of the scripture. If you're a true believer that has faith in God's word, no matter what your age is, you can lay hands on the sick in the name of Jesus, and they shall recover. You don't have to be a minister or a pastor. All you have to do is believe. The signs will follow you because you believe God's word is faith. So, let's get into the lesson and see what happens.
How is your mom doing after hearing your sister, Lizzie, has cancer?
My mom's holding up pretty well. We have a strong support system. Our family and church, they're all praying for Lizzie. But we haven't lost hope. I know that God will heal her.
Do you want to hear something really awesome?
Yeah.
Well, I heard a story where this man had cancer. The doctors told his family to prepare for the worst. Well, that family called this minister, his name is Minister Wallace, who had strong faith to pray for him. That minister went to the man's bedside, laid his hands on his forehead, and begins to pray a prayer of faith for that man. And guess what?
What?
The doctors were shocked. They told his family the next morning that they don't know what happened and that he doesn't have cancer anymore.
Awesome. I sure wish that I could find that minister.
I heard he goes to some church on 2nd Street. I'm not sure. Well, I have to get to my last hour class. I'm sure I can't be late for Mrs. Clark's class. She'll mark me absent in a minute.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Is your name Portia?
Yeah.
Do you mind if I have a seat?
Sure.
I thought your poster. I saw that you're looking for a minister for your sister who has cancer. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. I have money to pay.
You don't need to pay anyone for laying hands and praying for your sister. I'm sorry to hear about your sister. I saw that the poster stated that you're looking for Minister Wallace. Why Minister Wallace?
Well, I was looking for him because my friend told me about how he prayed for this man that was dying of cancer, and he was healed by God. I don't understand about healing the sick. How did that minister do that? I've been praying to God for my sister from the first day she was diagnosed with cancer, but my prayers, they don't seem to work. I read my Bible every day. Every time I go down to that hospital, her condition worsens. I just want us to go shopping together, like we used to, and have fun, riding our bikes. I miss that.
Portia. Do you know that you don't have to be a minister to lay hands on the sick? Healing the sick is part of every believer's responsibility. However, as a believer, we cannot do it alone. But the Holy Spirit is present to impart His power when we act in Jesus' name.
So you're saying I don't have to call for a minister? And that if I believe and lay hands on my sister in the name of Jesus, she'll recover?
It's nothing wrong with calling for a minister. Because the Bible says in James 5:14, is anyone among you sick? Let them call the elders of the church to pray over them and anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. However, Portia, God has given you, as a believer, the authority to lay hands on the sick in His name, and the sick shall recover. Healing is made available. Christ died and took every sickness and disease and nailed it to the cross. You are born again believer. Is that right?
Yeah.
So rather than look at how sick your sister is and feel pity for her, why don't you pull your hands out of your pockets and go lay them on your sister, just as Jesus did when he was ministering on the earth?
Thanks. I'm gonna go lay hands on my sister in the name of Jesus.
Well, guys, if you have a sick loved one that needs to be healed, you don't have to wait on a pastor or minister to pray for them to be healed. You can pray for them to be healed in Jesus' name if you believe. It doesn't matter what age you are, you can lay hands on the sick in faith. Don't lose hope if they don't get healed immediately. Always remember that our timing is not God's timing. Well, guys, that's it for this lesson. If you would like for me to pray for you, maybe you're lacking the faith you need to pray for others who are sick. Well, repeat after me. Dear God, I believe your word. In the name of Jesus, according to Mark 16 and 17 and 18, that I can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. I'm a believer that walks by faith and not by sight. No matter what it looks like, I know that all things are possible to them that believe in Jesus' name. Amen.